Hi, this is Renee Stanley for Movie Review Relay, and today we're talking about Ryan Reynolds. Do you like Ryan Reynolds? You should. I love that guy. Most people know him from Deadpool, but he's done so much. He's been around 30 years, Canadian actor, good kid. You never hear him talking nasty about people. He just seems to be a good guy. And a smart businessman. Got us all to buy Mint Mobile. And I think he sold it for billions of dollars. I don't know, for real. But my point is, yeah, he's a smart businessman as well. All right? We like him. Yeah, why not? All right, so let's talk about his movie, If. He's got a new film out this week. It's called If. And it's supposed to be a family feature. I saw it, and I'll tell you what I saw. If is on the premise of a little girl. Her name is Bee. Bee is stalked by a blue creature whose name is Blue. Blue's friend is the Ryan Reynolds character. The director of If is John Krasinski, and he also stars as the father. You know what I liked also, I'm going to say about our picture? Fiona Shore, I like her. Yeah, she played the grandmother. Kaylee Fleming is the star. She's the little girl whose father's sick, mother passed away. Now, I'm going to say this because a lot of people love these family films. I do too. But yeah, there is some death. Mother, cancer, father. You'll say I spoil it, but I'm just letting you know there is some references to some death. Just here and there, but I think it writers put that in, I think, because it gives the picture more heart. It gives the writer more opportunity to form a character arc around the other characters. So, yeah, there are some elements of mourning that you're gonna find not disturbing, but is a part of life, right? But overall, the animation is very well done. It's live action and animation together, and they did a good job, I think, and melding the two together. They look very nice. The colors are vibrant and beautiful. The costuming as well. I think John to co-star in the film, and it was a small part, I know that, but he did a good job. You're gonna enjoy this film. Take the kids out to see it. I think you'll have a good time. There wasn't a lot of people on preview night, but it was nighttime, and it's, you know, kids are in school or they gotta go to school the next day. This weekend, you take them on a Saturday or Sunday, I'm sure you have a wonderful time. 5 being the best, 1 being the worst. Yeah, we can give this film a 3 easily. And give it a 3.5 if you love animation. Like there's no tomorrow. yeah, go see our guy, Ryan Reynolds. And I'll have the guys put the rest of the cast listed here on the side of the screen, like I normally do, all right? Now, I just want to say this about the scary movie that's out this week. Do you guys remember Stranger, the first time it came out? All right, very scary. And it was just violent and terrible and gory. Now, when I say terrible, I'm not saying it was a bad picture. I'm saying it was terribly gory, the way they were killing people. And then what made it scary is that a house invasion can happen to anyone. It's not like a science fiction film, Thanos. You know, you don't really... Thanos was scary, but not that much. But when you have these types of films, like The Strangers, you got some jump scares, but they actually get in your face with these frightening images. So if you're faint of heart, this is not for you babies. Wait until something else, Mary Poppins or something like that comes along. Because you're gonna be scared out of your wits. You might be too frightened to walk out to the car. Yeah, I said that. Now, The Strangers came out in 2008. This is supposed to be a prequel to that, you know? Kind of like when we did the Pearl, which was a sequel to another horror picture. So this is before The Strangers of 2008. The Strangers Chapter 1 is directed by Rennie Harlan. Madeline Pish and Freud Gutierrez are a couple. They're out, you know, taking a road trip. Yeah, they're traveling. The car breaks down, of course. It's a desolate area. Yeah, now you got to go in the woods and you got to find a place to be safe until, you know, you can get home. All right, so little by little, you see these people that starts knocking at the door And pretty soon you realize that they're not friendly neighbors. And just like in the first picture, these murderers have masks on, which make them even scarier. Because you and I know your imagination is going to give you the scariest picture of what a murderer should look like. And it could look like anyone, especially if they're invading your home. It could be someone walking up the driveway right now. Yeah, I said that. All right, I'm just messing with you. All right, so I'm going to have the kids, again, put the credits on the side. 5 being the best, 1 being the worst. Yeah, Strangers, Chapter 1. Easy comes in at 3. Give it an extra star if you love the first one so much that you couldn't wait for them to make a sequel some 18 years later. And then there were a lot of people in the theater going to see The Amazing Spider-Man 2, which I think I told you guys last week. Everyone's going to do the Spider-Man thing. You know, the Spider-Man animation, Spider-Verse is going to be coming out. Until then, you're going to constantly see these Spider-Man movies. This week, it was The Amazing Spider-Man 2. Andrew Garfield never had a trilogy like some of the other Spider-Mans did. All right, so there were a lot of people there, though. Yeah, they were packed to see that picture. And I know what you're saying. Well, Renee, it's only $5 or whatever it is. And you might be right. Yeah, that maybe that's it. They could take it. It's a friendly, family-friendly film, and they could take it, the kids, and not break the bank. Okay. You know what was very well done? Billie English. She was on the big screen this weekend. I don't know what night. We saw her in the afternoon around 3 o'clock. It was packed. People loved her concert. All right, so Billie Eilish, Hit Me Hard and Soft, was beautiful. Now, don't go in there expecting like Taylor Swift or Beyonce. She has a different type of show, you know? But she has this beautiful voice. She's a wonderful songwriter, her and her brother, her family, okay? So I think you'll enjoy that if you just want to go to movies and have a nice little musical serenade. It's like she's serenading you, okay? Beautiful voice, everyone knows her. She's lovely, Grammy winner, you name it. You know, she's got all these awards. Futurosa, the Mad Max movie that's coming out next week. Seems to be pacing well. People have seen it. I haven't seen it yet. I'll let you know what I think next week. But yeah, people are coming out to see this. If you love Mad Max, this is going to be a must-see for you. All right, so you go ahead and get your ticket for that. In the meantime, they're coming out with a movie in the theaters. It should be interesting. It's about the 1960s NASA program. It's about a marketer who's trying to make the space program popular throughout the country during the 1960s. Yeah, they're dealing with NASA. And it's the romantic spring between the two characters. Tatum Channing and Scarlett Johansson. I'm there. Also, Ray Romano, Woody Harrelson. There's a lot of good guys that are going to be in this film. Jim Rush, Noah Robbins, Colin Woodall, Anna Garcia, Nick Gillenberg, and all right, and you guys know I'm not the gossip girl. I've said this before, but you keep asking me about Puffy. Puffy should know better, okay? He's a seasoned musician, producer, you name it. Walk away. I don't care how mad you get at somebody, man or woman, but especially not a woman. I always tell young men, go around the block, get in your car, run away. Don't ever put your hands on a woman. And he knows better. Now, I can forgive Chris Brown before I forgive Puffy. But not that Puffy's looking for my forgiveness. Anyway, I realize that. Okay, but Chris Brown was a kid. What was he, 19 when he did that with Rihanna? And I condemned him too. But here's the point. Puffy, you're rusty. You know what? I'm not gonna go there. I'm just saying, you too grown, you should know better. If your parents didn't teach you not to hit a woman or mistreat a woman, you should know that by now. As old as you are and as experienced as you are with the legal system and the people around you going through such torment with the legal system. What were you thinking? All right, so, yeah, we didn't like it. We saw it once and we could barely get through that video. that hurts me when you treat a woman like that. I don't care if she stole your gold Rolex. You're a billionaire. Get you another one. Take it to court. You don't handle it that way. I don't know what the fight was about. It doesn't matter. Never put your hands on women. You kicked. It was just violent. It was some violent stuff like I've seen in the movies. All right. I'm finished. All right, guys. Let's go watch the game. Until we meet again, congratulations, the Knicks. Congratulations, Indiana. Okay? See? I said them both. Because I know every once in a while I get one of y'all from the Midwest be coming at me, all right? But I love you anyway. Until we meet again, it's Renee Stanley from Movie Review Relay.